Oh, girls' room. Very nice. Door to the women's restroom. Wow. Okay, let's go inside. Probably nothing here. Nope. Not much. What the hell? Salisbury steak? Who the hell puts a steak in a tub? I'll take it. Must be a VIP. Oh, biohazard. Whatever. Okay. Whoop, there's somebody over there. Ah, it's just a settler. A common house. Alright. Whoa, a lot of people here. A little bit of too many people here. I could take it though. That's what it says. It says I could just grab it. Yeah, look at that. Oh, they don't have anything here. Alright. What else we got? I'm stuck on something. Yeah, I got the police uniform still on. Oh, don't want to do that. I want to go in front of it. It's over here. Here we go. Look at that, I'm just gliding through the world. There he is.
Colin Moriarty. Always pleased to see a new face. But I'm afraid you've had the misfortune to catch me, well, out of me element. I'm the owner and proprietor of Moriarty's, you see. The saloon? But please, see for yourself. Come by for a drink or 12. You and I, oh,
we're 12.
Fast friends. Fast friends.
I'm looking for my father, middle-aged guy. Maybe you've seen him?
My God, it's you. The little baby boy all grown up. Persistent little bastard, ain't you?
Yes.
And then now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here, all right. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct?
You're lying. The vault's been sealed for 200 years.
God in heaven, would you listen to yourself? Do you honestly believe that's true? The lies they've put in that head of yours. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well. You stayed in my saloon, after all. That's right. Your father, his Brotherhood of Steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mum.
Is that right?
Truly. But no matter. That big round door is open now, hasn't it? Daddy's gone, and you need to know why. Could be I know where and why.
Huh. Oh, I wasn't born in the vault? That's complete bullshit, and you know it.
Ah, I see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there. From some other fella, escaped. Oh, 5 years back. All hail the overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You'd best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you, hmm?
Huh. Let's cut to the chase. How much for you to tell me where my father is?
You catch on quick, kid. That's the way of it out here, for sure. You want something, you take it. Or you pay in cold, hard caps. Say, 100. Seems a fair price to facilitate
100
a family
caps.
Reunion, don't you think?
I don't have 100 caps. Or do I? Oh, whatever, here.
Excellent. Your dad raised a smart kid. Really no substitute for the love of a father, now is there? Speaking of dear old dad, he went southeast, into DC, to the Galaxy News radio station. Good luck now.
Okay. Anything else you want to tell me?
You're still standing here, and I can't think why. You know where your father went.
What's all this about the Galaxy News Radio?
Galaxy News Radio is some loudmouth radio station located in the ruins of DC. Three Dog, the king of that loony bin, keeps yapping about fighting some good fight or something. A bunch of crap. But I suppose if you wanted to know what was going on in the wasteland, that's the place to go. Me, I could care less.
So what do you do around here?
I keep these yokels knee-deep in booze and poon. They keep me knee-deep in caps. It's a fair trade,
poon,
if you ask
me. Sounds good to me. Okay. Let me go check this place out. Poon, huh? I don't mind some little poon right now. I've been in a vault for, like, forever. Since I was born.
Come on, you beast.
Hey there.
Hey. How much for a room? What's the story with that ghoul? What is it? What's it take to hire you?
It takes you renting a room. Sleep in it or don't. I don't care. I get paid either way.
Huh. How much for a room?
Well, for you, a room and some company will run you
120 caps.
Up front.
Oh, Jesus. No thanks. Okay. What were you saying about the radio stations?
Huh? Oh. You mean why was Gob banging on that
radio? I don't
think
she did, but whatever.
Well, out there in the wastes, there are two stations that broadcast. There's the Enclave station. I don't know who they are, but I think it might just be some pre-war broadcast on a loop or something.
That's for sure.
And there's Galaxy
News. It's that annoying patriotic music.
It's run by a guy named Three Dog, somewhere down in D.C. But the signal went down a while ago.
Hmm. What's the story with that ghoul?
Who? Gob? Well, if you can get past how he looks, he's a sweetheart. Colin's awfully hard on him, though.
Where'd he come from?
He don't talk about it much, but apparently there's a whole city of ghouls somewhere down in D.C. He's mentioned his mother a couple of times, but other than that, he won't really say. He's been here for, I guess about 15 years now, ever since Moriarty bought him off those slavers.
Hmm. Do you ever, work with him?
With Gob? Well, he's sweet, and I know that he'd like to. It's just, well,
he's a ghoul.
I don't want to sound shallow or anything. I mean, I'm a whore. My standards aren't exactly high. There are places even I won't go. Johnnies that are squishier than me are one of them.
Wow, okay. That's something. So why is he so hard on him?
Well, the miserable bastard is hard on all of us. But Gob gets it the worst. I guess just because he's different, you know?
Hmm. Yeah, that's true. Let's talk about something else.
Sure thing, baby.
What's the word around town?
I couldn't tell you, really. I talked to Manya, if you care that much. She's lived in Megaton longer than anyone.
Manya. All right, that's enough.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave station comes in fine. It's
Hey, Smoothskin.
Ugh, look at this guy.
Drink, maybe? Anything? Anything at all?
Oh, fuck, what are you?
Haven't you ever seen a ghoul before?
I know what a ghoul is. Now, get away from me, zombie.
Yeah, great. What do you need? Asshole.
Where'd you come from?
A place called Underworld. It's a ghoul city down in D.C. I set off up here to find adventure and fortune. And, well, I found this place.
I'm sort of stuck here. Colin says that I can't leave until I pay off my debt to him. Of course, he charges me room and board, too. If you ever get to Underworld, tell Carol that I said hi.
Who the hell's Carol? Ugh, whatever. Goodbye, Gob.
Don't hit me.
Oh, well, I don't need to freaking sell anything. I got beer. All right. Who's this guy?
My. Just when I had all but given up hope. My dear boy,
I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke.
Mr. Burke?
You, well, you are not a resident of this putrescent cesspool. And makes you a rather valuable individual.
Mr. Burke, is it? Well, please continue. I find myself enthralled.
Finally, someone with a modicum of civility and common sense. I represent certain interests, and those interests view this town, this megaton, as a blight on a burgeoning urban landscape. You have no connections here, no interest in this cesspool's affairs or fate.
Not really.
You can assist us in erasing this little accident off the map.
Go on, I'm listening.
The undetonated atomic bomb for which this town is named is still very much alive. All it needs is a little motivation. I have in my possession a fusion pulse charge, constructed for a singular purpose. The detonation of that bomb. You'll rig it to the bomb, then you'll get paid. Handsomely. What do you say?
Throw in an extra 500 caps and you get yourself a deal.
Is that the best you can do? I'm afraid I'm not impressed.
I guess I'm gonna have to boost my speech. You're out of your mind, Burke. There's no way... Alright, Mr. Burke. I'll do it. Megaton will burn. Just not now.
Excellent. I have a feeling about you. Here's the fusion pulse charge. It needs to be installed inside the bomb. When it's done, meet me at Tenpenny Tower. It's southwest of here, well out of harm's way. You can't miss it. Questions?
We're talking a lot of instant lives here, Burke. Nope, I don't want to do that. Messing with that bomb seems pretty technical. What if I can't do it?
Lack the aptitude, you mean? You're not rewiring the thing, just attaching the pulse charge to the detonator.
Oh, okay.
If you get stumped, talk to Leo Stahl. He might have something to help you concentrate. He's got a bit of a reputation.
Okay. Time for me to go.
Don't let me keep you.
Who's this guy? Make Jericho.
Yeah, look. Another one of you wasteland assholes. Look here, asshole. I don't like you. Stay
yeah, I don't like you either.
We'll have no trouble.
You don't look like you belong here. What's your story?
There ain't much to tell. I used to live out in the wastes. I was a real bastard back then. I've put all that behind me.
Have you ever considered getting back out there?
What? Back out where?
Out there in the waste, man. You must be bored to tears in this town.
I left all that behind me. There's nothing but bullshit out there. Killing, stealing, violence. I'm not that guy anymore.
Yeah, killing, stealing. Sounds fun, doesn't it?
You know, I do miss it sometimes. It's a life of freedom, you know? But come on, I'm a washed-up old raider. What crew is gonna take me on? These kids don't know nothing about respect.
You should come with me. I could use a hand.
No offense, kid. But you're not exactly the type I'm used to running with. I've heard about you. A little goody-two-shoes out of the vault.
Goody-two-shoes?
Styles would really mesh.
You sure you've heard about me?
It ain't so bad here. I got some good memories, but that's all I got. Sense in ruining the good ones, you know?
Your comment's too high. Wow, really? I have to go now. I'll be back. My karma's too high. I didn't steal enough, I guess.
That's what cost you.
Yeah, you need something?
I guess I'm gonna have to kill some people. Not now, though.
So, what is it now?
Nothing. Leave me alone. Oh, wait, who is that guy? Nathan!
Ah, look at this! New blood? Tell me, boy, you ever hear of the Enclave? The last remnant of the good old USA they are. Now, I don't know you from Adam, but I got you pegged for a patriot, and any patriot worth his salt is gonna toss his gun in for the Enclave. Any day now, they're gonna roll up here, and then this nightmare will be over for good. But listen to me, Ramble. I'm Nathan. What can I do for you?
So why do you support the Enclave?
Why? Why? Look around you. This is the good old USA. Sure, she looks a little bit different these days, but you're still on American soil. And even if you were born in some underground vault, you were born under the United States, which makes you an American.
Sure.
And it's your duty and my duty to support our country and our president, no matter what. Understand?
Support the country that put me in the vault in the first place? Are you kidding me? It's the duty of a citizen to question his government.
Why? That's unthinkable. Where in the Constitution does it say that we're supposed to run around questioning the government, huh?
Well, they did give us guns and say, if we fuck up, feel free to take us out.
Well, when you put it that way, wait. You're just trying to confuse me with your fancy vault education and your textbooks. I'll have none of it. Did you have something else you wanted to ask, or were you done with your crazy talk?
If you've never seen the Enclave, how can you know anything about them?
They're on the radio. They have
well, so
been
what?
For years. President Eden talks about everything they're doing. They got flying robots all around, watching everything.
That makes them better?
So they know what to do when they finally swoop in and clean this place up. You'll see. People think I'm just a crazy old man. Things will be different when the Enclave gets here.
Huh. Yeah, right. Hey. Yeah, sure. You believe on freaking controlling a government that controls you forever? That's a good idea. Let's go with that. Yeah, it's a good government, you know. Puts everybody in the vault except you, guy. You didn't get put in the vault. Yeah, well, whatever. That's politics. I don't care about politics right now. Alright, good. Supplies. Gonna do some selling, some buying and selling. Let's go talk to this bitch. We meet again.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
No, I don't want to do anything with them anymore.
If you say so. But if you really mean that, you might want to stop wearing a suit with their number written large across the back. Anyway, I guess I don't
That's
need
so
a
true.
Forward. They just get in the way of the real content. But the book's going to be great. You just watch.
So what is this book you're working on?
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
Tell me more about the pay.
Caps, chems, meds, and maybe even a few unique inventions, if you do a good job. I'm sure I've got something that'll catch your eye. With a little ingenuity, you can turn a pile of junk into a mountain of caps. And there's no shortage of junk, so you help out.
Sounds like a great idea. Okay, I guess I'll help with this survival guide.
All right, then. Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which
what
do you want to do
first?
What
the hell is wrong with this girl? Well, getting food doesn't sound so bad. What are you looking for?
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
So what's the pay?
Hopefully, you'll be finding food and medicine. But I could sweeten the deal by paying more food when you get back, regardless of the results. While you're away, I can at least search through my junk and see if there's anything that'll go with old food to make it more appetizing.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
Okay. Oh, we got another quest. Do you sell any specialty items?
Oh, do I ever. I've got the schematics for something called a rocket launcher. I sell all the components, too, so you can make the weapon yourself. Don't worry about ammo. This baby shoots all the junk you might find out there in the wasteland. Ashtrays, teddy bears, you name it. In fact,
sounds like fun.
If you ever need to make any custom weapons, feel free to use my workbench here in the shop. All you need is the schematics and parts.
Okay, so let's see what you have.
Abs.
Wow, that schematic is expensive. Look at that. A rocket launcher schematic. 1,100 caps. So that's it.
Can good hunting.
Ooh, wait a minute. I'm gonna get some ammo. Okay. I don't think I have a 556. What's used as a 550? Oh, the assault rifle. Why not? Okay. And then let me sell the rest of my miscellaneous stuff. This truck. Central modules. Scorch book. I don't know why I have that. Sell the steak. Should be plenty of food at the supermarket. Probably go in there first anyway. Alright.
Good hunting.
Can you repair my items? Damn, 156? Screw that. Who's this guy?
I'm just here to make sure nothing goes wrong with you or her.
I can't really do anything in here. Oh well. Let's see who's up here. Water processing plant. Doesn't look like there's anybody here. Nope. Take that. Alright. Bunch of miscellaneous stuff. Huh. Very hard. I don't think I could break that just yet. I think that's about all I could do here. Let's go. Oh, look at this guy. Walter.
Yeah, what is it?
What do you do around here?
I take care of the water purification plant. That old rusted hunk keeps us in clean water.
He's not even talking. He wasn't even talking. He's not even moving his lips. What's the word around town?
People have been saying that the water purifier's about to go. Honestly, I'll tell you what I tell them. I've been keeping that wreck going for 35 years, and this is the first time I've ever had a problem I couldn't fix.
All right, that's it. How much else I could do here? What else? We made about a full circle here. Lucas Sims, that's the sheriff. Don't want to deal with that right now. I think that's about it. Yep, that takes me up to the supplies. That's the clinic. That's the food. The saloon. I went almost everywhere. Let's go to the super duper camp.
You looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
Does it matter?